A common request we've been receiving recently is how to paint crypt ghouls really quickly to enable you to get large hordes of them on the tabletop. So today we're going to show you a great method of doing this using one miniature, but what we recommend that you do is paint your whole unit in a production line method following with these colours. Now to start out with, what you need to do is undercoat your miniature with Mechanica Standard Grey, which you can see is what I've done with my miniature just here, but you could start from Xandrida Spray if you prefer. But the paints you need to apply are Nurgling Green first of all, followed by Athonian Camo Shade. You're also going to need Ushabti Bone, also some Mechanica Standard Grey, Rhinox Hide, and also Agrax Earthshade. Now to begin with, what we need is Nurgling Green, which I'm going to be applying using my medium base brush, and what you need to do is, as always, use your palette to get the paint ready by adding just a touch of water into the mix so it's nice and smooth, and once you've done so, all you need to do is apply this all over the skin. So just be sure to take your time working it into all the little nooks and crannies and apply a second thin coat to make sure it's nice and even before you move on to the next step. Once you've got all the miniatures in the unit painted to this point, you're then ready to apply a coat of Athonian Camo Shade all over the flesh, applied using a medium shade brush. Once the shade is completely dry, we're then ready to highlight the skin by lightly dry brushing it using a Ushabti Bone, just very lightly like this so that the colour's not too stark. Then, still using a Ushabti Bone, this time applied with a medium layer brush, you need to pick out all the bones, the teeth and the claws as well. Next, if your ghoul's holding a rock, you need to base coat this using Mechanica Standard Grey, again using a medium layer brush. And then, using Rhinox Hide, base coat any rags and also the hair. And finally, apply Agrax Earthshade over every detail except for the green skin using a medium layer brush so that you can keep control of it. And there we are, the ghoul is fully painted and ready to be based. Now remember, if you're painting a large amount of these, a great way to do them is to set up a production line and just work your way through them all at the same time, and they'll be done before you know it. But for you flesh-eater court players out there, I really hope this is useful, and we'll see you all again soon.